our story today. It's going to transport us in time a little bit. So let's move our calendar to the month of Adar. So would someone like to move our calendar to Adar so that we can talk about the story of Esther? Story is in the Tanakh, but not in the first five books, not in the Torah scroll, but in the other part. So we take our story from the shelves that relate both to the festivals and also our Tanakh. So the story, when you want to use it, will be over this time. Are we ready for a story? Long ago, the Jews lived in the land of Persia. A young woman by the name of Esther. And her uncle, who had looked after her since she was a baby, called Mordechai. The king of all the land of Persia, King Ahasuerus. Rules throughout the whole land. He had a grand palace. He held many, many parties in his palace. And one time he decided that he needed a new queen for his kingdom. And he sent for all the beautiful young women in the land. And he looked upon Esther and chose her to be his queen. She came to live in the palace. But Esther had a secret. Esther was a Jew. But she did not tell the king, for she was afraid. Her uncle Mordechai sat outside the palace each day. And one day he heard plot to kill the king, and he told Esther, and Esther told the king, and the king wrote it down in the book of records. Had a minister whose name was Haman. And Haman felt he was a very important person. And he would go out into the kingdom and expect everyone to bow down to him. But one person would not bow down to him, and that was Mordechai. And Haman was very angry that Mordechai would not bow down to him. And he said to the king, "Mordechai the Jew will not bow down to me. Please give me permission to kill him and all the Jews." And Haman gave money to the king
Haman took Purim, lots, in order to decide which day to kill the Jews. And the lot fell on the 13th. Put on sackcloth to show how sad he was. And when Esther heard that Mordechai was feeling so sad, she told him to feel better and to be happy. But Mordechai told Esther that she would need to go to the king and tell the king that she was a Jew. But Esther knew that no one could enter the king's palace without being asked, and if they did, they would be killed. And so Esther fasted for 3 days, and she asked all her people to fast with her. And she said, "I will go to the king, and if I die, shall die." After 3 days, she went into the king's part of the palace. She was afraid, but the king welcomed her and asked her what she wanted. Esther was not ready to tell her secret, but she invited the king and Haman to come to her rooms in the palace for a party. The king asked again what Esther wanted from them, but she was not ready to tell her secret. So she invited them to come back a second night for another party. That night, the king did not sleep well. When he awoke, he asked to see the book of records. And there, he saw that Mordechai had not been thanked for saving his life. And he asked Haman what he should do to honor someone. And Haman, thinking it was him, said he should dress the person in the king's clothes and ride on the king's horse. And the king told Haman to do just that for Mordechai. Haman was very angry, but he dressed Mordechai in the king's clothes and he rode on the king's horse around the kingdom. Haman was very angry indeed, but was pleased to go back to Esther the next night. Esther said to the king, "I am a Jew, and Haman is intending to kill us all." The king was very angry and decided to kill Haman in the place where Mordechai would have been killed. He made Mordechai his minister. And they ruled the land together. And on the 14th of Adar, they celebrated the festival of Purim, remember that Esther had the courage to tell her secrets and to save the Jews. So I wonder,
part of the story did you like?